You know, this is life-saving. They have nowhere else to turn for food or for security than in these camps.
It was important for me to come here because I needed food for my children. My name is Habiba Isaac. We came from Somalia by foot, and we had a donkey cart for carrying the smaller kids. We spent 15 nights on the road just to get to this place.
A woman who had little to hope for is now getting support and food in her new situation in Kenya's refugee community, thanks to the work of multiple humanitarian agencies, including the United Nations World Food Programme, or WFP.
My situation is good. I'm very happy because I was able to receive food in a short period.
She is now settled safely in a community with thousands of people like her, who fled poverty, hunger, and other life-threatening challenges. Each of these three refugee camps in Dadaab is designed to accommodate 50,000 refugees. Each camp now has double that number. The process to receive food is secure and orderly.
The person who's in front of you is the same person who's appearing in the photo.
Each refugee registers for assistance and provides basic data. They go through a biometric screening. They obtain identification to present at the beginning of each month when they line up to receive their family's rations. The WFP distributes cereals and carbohydrates, maize, sorghum, rice, and sometimes wheat, pulses and proteins, yellow split peas or beans, and vegetable oil. In addition to this, each registered refugee receives a cash transfer, currently about $7 each month. This food is provided by the World Food Programme, thanks to the support of donors like the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints. The WFP helps people throughout the world. Nourishment protects families and keeps them together.
It's important for me to go and collect food because that is what my family relies on. I have come from Somalia because of conflict and because of drought, especially now it's even worse. I would want a place that is stable, that is peace for me and my grandchildren and also my children.
Hassan Ali Ise.
My name is Hassan Ali Ise. I came from Kismayo, Somalia. What motivates me is because there is food available that we as refugees can be able to go and collect. It kind of helps us to top up what we would otherwise not have had.
Mohammed also came from Somalia. His mother is blind and his father is disabled with several health challenges. He has goals that can change the course of his life.
Because of
my wish to become a doctor is because I would want to give back to my community and do something meaningful. The food we receive helps us in some ways, especially the oil we get from the food distribution centers really help us to sustain our cooking in the family.
Relief workers face a growing challenge of more refugees, rising food costs, and 5 straight years of drought in the Horn of Africa. But they do not hesitate to respond.
You know, this is life-saving. They have nowhere else to turn for food or for security than in these camps. When people come here and they see the camps for the first time, there's a bit of shock, right, in terms of the situation that individuals and families are living in. But then if you take the time to sit down and speak with some of the mothers, speak with some of the children, you know, play with some of the children around, you see that, again, the circumstances might be different, but they are just like you and I.
I'm able to go to the refugee camps and ensure that the refugees are receiving their food entitlement in a more dignified and safe manner, to just make sure I'm putting a smile on their face.
Relief workers want continued progress in the camp. They say they dream of peace in the former countries of the refugees, a better outcome for all, especially those who have so much valuable time ahead.
The hope that parents have to give their children a better future, that is something that is universal.
Yeah.